Hey guys, who is chillin'? My name is Lonely Mailbox, and if you just recognized my old intro, and then you know, I'm glad to hear it because maybe it brought back some old mailbox memories. I don't know. All I know is that it was my old classic, stupid, corny intro that I used to say all the time, man. And for some reason, a lot of people enjoyed it, so I figured I'd bring it back for one video. You know, why not? We could call it Throwback Mailbox. I don't really know. But today, guys, I'm actually going to be telling you something that I really don't tell anybody anymore. But today, I'll be talking about it. It's actually pretty interesting, but at the same time, it's really, really pathetic, and I think you guys are going to get a kick out of it. However, I would really appreciate it if you guys could just help me out a little bit and just like this video if you do end up enjoying the commentary, because obviously, you know, likes and ratings are a huge factor to growing a channel, and just lately I haven't been getting that many ratings, so it would be much appreciated if you could just mouse over the like button and, you know what, give it a handsome click. I don't really know if clicks can be handsome, but I'll have to Google that. Anyway, guys, if you don't have the time to leave a like, or if you don't want to, I completely understand, but let's get into this little story. Alright, so back when I was about 8 years old, I joined this little father and son group type thing with, of course, my dad, and I guess you could kind of refer to it as like a Boy Scouts type thing, but from what I heard, it was a lot different. I don't know, you could just call it kind of like a father and son type thing. Anyway, guys, being in this group, me and my dad actually got to go on little like camping trips every now and then, and travel once in a while, but like the third year we were in this little group, we ended up going to this campground place with a bunch of other dads and sons that we had pretty much, you know, befriended throughout the years of being in this little organization. And one morning, the dads decided to just get out of the tents, leave the kids sleeping, and just cook up some pancakes for breakfast. Well, after a while, everybody woke up. You know, we all went outside, we munched down on pancakes, and eventually everybody got full, right? You know, after having such a good time and eating all these pancakes. Well, I guess there was this tradition at this place where you're supposed to feed your leftover breakfast to these pigs that they had here. And I don't know why they had pigs here. I guess they may have had other farm animals. I don't really remember this. This was a few years ago. I don't remember why this was a tradition, but like all the kids took a little stack of leftover pancakes, and we walked with our dads over to these pens where we would just literally toss them in there and watch these pigs swallow them whole. Now, here's the thing. At the time, for whatever reason, I really don't know why, I don't know how I came to think this, but I happened to think that these pancakes were actually made out of pigs, so I found this freaking hilarious, man. I mean, call me cool, you know, call me evil, but I just went crazy, like, just laughing, watching these pigs slurp up little pieces of their friends and relatives. I mean, that's what I thought that they were eating, and some of these dads must have thought that I was, like, special ed, just like, you know, watching me laugh my butt off at these pigs who were just eating pancakes. But looking back at it now, you know, I guess I realize how freaking mean that would be. I mean, just like pig cannibalism, come on, dude, that's like evil. But I didn't really talk about it at the camp. I kind of just thought it was the normal thing. You know, I thought that everybody knew that pancakes were made out of pigs. But, you know, I was pretty young. I was immature. Of course, now I realized that that would be wrong on so many levels. But, yeah, I mean, I went on thinking for like a year or so more that pancakes were, in fact, made out of pigs. And I ended up figuring the truth out at school one day in elementary school. I don't remember how the subject was brought up or anything. I just remember my friends laughing their asses off at me. And, you know, it was just stupid for me to believe that. I don't even know how that entered my mind. But I do remember, however, like this. There was like this little story. I don't really remember what it was. It was like, if a pig makes a pancake, I think it was something. I think it was that. No, if you give a pig a pancake, I probably thought that that little like children's book was pretty funny too. Just because, you know, again, I thought that it was literally like a pig being given another pig in the form of food, and I probably cracked up at that too. But, you know, later on I realized that I was very, very wrong. And, you know, that's pretty much it, guys. It's just a little interesting fact about me. I mean, I know it's kind of weird, but if you guys did enjoy this video, again, it would be awesome if you could leave a like rating. There's two other videos on the screen if you want to check them out, and I will see you guys next time. It has been LM.